Stevie Wonder?
The winner of Australian Idol 2003 is... Guy Sebastian.
just as cool as it did last night. That was the same stretched Porsche you guys saw it in the video that I pulled up here 20 years ago, where my life changed. I didn't know what I was getting myself into, neither did Shannon. We were so green and so nervous, but we've locked up here, and I guess then 20 years has happened since then. But what an incredible, incredible way to start. I had people vote for me. Like, literally, it cost 55 cents. That was 20 years ago. Think about it. That's like $5 now with inflation. And people voted multiple times so that I could do this for a living. And that's always stuck with me. It's the ultimate exchange of kindness. And I'll never, ever forget it. Now, this jacket's very tight. Jonty, can you... You gotta roll it. It's like stuck to my arms. Jeez. That's a lot of effort for just half a song, isn't it? This jacket, my mum and dad have flown in. I bought this in an op shop in Nashville. A long time ago, this is before Idol, I was touring in the band, and I was in Nashville and I saw this jacket. It was like $10 or something. US, but our dollar was better back then, so it was a bargain. This is the jacket I wore in that audition. My mum brought it. It doesn't smell moldy. She's kept it very well in the cupboard. Where are you, mum? You guys are sitting here. There we go. My mum's also brought the original Afro wig. Have you got my mum on camera? There you go. Mum, hold that flag up. So it's got Shannon on one side. That's from that evening. What else did you bring? My son is wearing the OG Australian Idol merch. Huddy, stand up. There you go. That is the OG t-shirt my dad brought. This still fits. It's a little big and way too warm to be wearing this, but I won't spend all night just talking about random things I wore 20 years ago, I promise. Let's sing some songs. Should we do that? I sang this on the show 20 years ago. Baby girl, where you at? Got no strings, got many tags. Can't stop that feeling for long, no. You're making dogs want to beg, breaking them off your fence. I'm with her, I'm with her, I'm with her, I'm with her, I'm with her. to sit and observe, we're here to sing. Are you ready? Love you too. All right. You weren't alive when I won Idol. How old are you? You're 12 tomorrow. So you and Mike, happy birthday. Should we sing a quick a cappella happy birthday? Gary, you take the bass. Done. What's your name? Piper, cool name. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Piper. Happy birthday to you. You're 12 as well. You were minus 8. What's his name? Henry. How old is Henry? 7. Oh my gosh, you were minus 13. Well, I had a song that I had written when I was a kid. It was, I think, still in my teens when I wrote this song, and it made my very first album, which I recorded in 5 days. It's a throwback. It's called All I Need Is You. Sing a song tonight which so many people still to this day tell me, when you sang that song from Sound of Music, I'm not joking, still to this day people are like, that's when I knew you were gonna win. I knew it. If sports bet existed. But so many people have told me that. I remember that moment. I had been to a Prince concert the night before and I was so inspired. I think it was just lit this thing up inside of me, and I remember singing Climb Every Mountain, and I still love singing it to this day. thank you so much. Whew. I knew. I just knew it. I've got something pretty special. Idol has helped so many of us. At the end of the day, it's a platform. And then it's up to whoever has been given that chance to run with it, and so many have. And one of those people who's so kind, so hardworking, and has an incredible voice and an incredible heart is Ricky Lee. Please make her welcome. She's gonna help me sing this next song, The Art of Love. This won't always go to plan, but we don't need to take our love for granted. It's in our nature to forgive what matters. Yeah.
And when the going is getting tough, and when we're all about giving up, things that we never thought we'd say, gonna say it. Games that we never thought we'd play, gonna play it.
See, it ain't perfect, but it's worth it.
And it's always getting better. Take some time to get it right.
Cause I'm still learning the art of love. I'm still trying and I mess up. So whenever I stumble, let me know. You need to spread it out.
You need to spread it out.
You need to spread it out.
You need to spread it out for me.
Cause I'm still trying. Hurt you, it's not my intention.
Cause we're gonna make my mistakes. I know how much your heart can take, but I know that you got my back.
You got my back.
And baby, I've got you.
Cause I'm still learning the art of love. I'm still trying to mess up. So whenever I stumble, let you know. Something at you, I would. That was such great singing. My goodness. Just throw my shoe or whatever we do in there. It's so weird that we throw things in our business when someone's good. I was in the US not too long ago. That's They're cicadas, by the way, I learned last night. That's what those things are, right? That noise. What note is that?
It's sharp.
Gary, you've got perfect pitch.
I can't tell what this pitch is.
It's so annoying. You need some bug spray or something. Anyway, I was going to tell a random story that I don't really need to tell, to be honest. I should just sing the next song, otherwise we'll run out of time. I'm going to sing as many songs as I can. I love this next one. This was the title track of an album called Madness.
shooting Cupid on a shooting spree, feeling stupid cause I know it ain't no you and me. But when you're trying to beat the odds up and trying to keep your nods up, and you know that you should know and let it go, but the fear of the unknown hold another lover's phone, send you back into the zone with no Tom Hanks to bring it home. A lover, not a fighter on the front line with a poem, trying to write yourself a rifle, maybe sharpen up a stone to fight the tanks and drones and you being alone.
Stop loving you so much, cause I'm the only one that's trying to keep us together. When all of the signs say that I should forget her, I wish you weren't the best I ever had. Instead the good outweigh the bad, cause it'll never be over. She tell me it's over. These bad.
Then he yelled, go ahead, it's a breather. hurts this song. Well, then you better sing along, right? Sing it cute.
That song, I think that was was that 2008? I think so. All right. Is it just coming to me? No, it is loud. Gee whiz. The Sebastian Foundation. We started that, Jules and I started that about 10 years ago, and we're just completely blown away with where it's got to now. We started it a small foundation, and our dream was to create something that really tackled the issue of youth mental health. And we found this incredible program called Open Parachute. It's a peer-to-peer program which is in schools, and what does that mean? That basically it's a time that they spend in a classroom where they watch videos of other kids their own age talk about certain issues, and those issues range from, you know, anxiety and depression and boundaries and harm and all that sort of stuff, and just issues that all kids face. And it basically then goes into this structured time where they learn those skills to have a mental armor on how to actually tackle these issues and not to let it get too big for them. I think it's such an important thing, and we're currently in over 150 schools. We're funding 80,000 plus kids across the country to go through this. And it's been incredible. It cost us as a foundation $15 per kid for the whole year. And we did a big walk, which I don't know if I'll do again. It was 500 kilometres. We walked from Wagga to Sydney. And it was, you know, I know it's the thing, it's just walking. It's like 12 hours or something. I'm our friend Albert here, he came and picked us. He picked up the support vehicle and he saw the state of us. We were pretty cooked by about day 8. But we got through and we raised over $1 million. So that was incredible. We just feel like it's such an important issue and we've been so blown away. So I just want to thank everybody who's been able to support the foundation and our work in these schools. I wrote a song a little while ago. It's called Standing With You. And I think it's one of those songs that the message is timeless, because I don't think there's a time in history where there isn't crazy things going on. But obviously the world's in a crazy, crazy state. And it's important for us to remind each other that we're there for each other, we're there for one another, we're there to listen, we're there to love, and that's what this song talks about. You can do this. The more you tell yourself you're useless, and need advice right now is fruitless. You're somewhere only you can go. I won't pretend to know. So instead of telling you you'll be alright, I'm just gonna be that someone by your side. Oh, let me be that distant satellite, a constant in the sky. To dive back into. Thank you. I was lucky enough. Now, that song I sung before, Battle Scars.
Woo!
It's crazy when you have a song, and there's some friends I've seen, Louis and other people that I've collaborated with and worked with throughout the years, and you never know. We write songs and we think, oh, this one's fantastic. This one's a hit. You can turn these off. I think that, can you hear that, the fans through this? It's like, as much as I like it, I feel very fancy having fans on me. I'm like Madonna or something. I can kind of hear it coming through. But you never know, you know, you write this song and you think, oh, this is a smash, and then you release it and no one cares. And then there's other songs that I wrote, like when I wrote Who's That Girl, that went number one for me. And when I got to the end of that, it literally says, it's like, can you unmute me? There we go. It's like, who's that girl just walked in the club? Tell me who's that girl just walked in the club? Tell me who's that girl just walked in the club? Just walked in the club. That's the lyrics. I remember my A&R guy at the time saying, do you want to add some more words or something to the poem? And I was like, oh, look, I'm putting it on this, like, it was this sort of greatest hits compilation thing, and I put it on, and then that goes number one. But Battle Scars, my gosh, I never knew that was going to do what it did. It took me around the world. I got to perform on David Letterman and so many other incredible opportunities that I received off the back of that. But another song that I recorded, I wrote this in LA, and I had Lupe Fiasco guest on this one. It's called Linger. Getting kinda used to fading every time. I guess we both refuse to face it. Ooh. Neither one of us will ever change our stripes. Why are we dancing now that the party's over?
On and on and on and on. make it last to the last one. Each release is just a lease that repeats the past one. Song that never ends, that was Lamb Chop Exodus. But the sexiness is a welcome back back to Jam Rock. So even when the band stop, guitar's still playing. And even though the hand's not, and all of this amounts to poltergeist and heart and eyes and stuff. Even when we die, we'll still be alive. Why can't we dance now that the party's over? Race is done. And yet we try to back on, baby. There's no way we can control it if we can't pull the trigger. The baby let this linger, linger on and on, on and on, on and on. Linger on and on, on and on, on and on. Ladies and gentlemen, Dyke Tweedy. This one yet, but I wrote it. You saw me check out one of the hot chicks in the aisles, my wife Jules, who looks beautiful tonight. It was her birthday not too long ago, and I was away for her birthday. I thought, instead of getting a present, and it wasn't thrifty, it wasn't like I was trying to be like cheap or anything, I thought I would write her a song, and I had this idea for a song, and sometimes it's these ideas are the hardest to write. It was what I was talking about before. Some songs I'll spend 5 minutes writing and it just comes out, and then others I really need to craft the lyrics. And this one I spent a bit of time on it, and I recorded a version of it, and I sent it to Jules on her birthday, just a demo of it. But I'm gonna record this and I'm gonna put it on the next album. It's a song about a song. It's you'll get it once you hear it, but it's basically saying there's like so many songs that say a certain thing about how beautiful and how perfect you are. Like this song says this thing and this other song says this thing, but there's no song that says it all. And so this is a song about writing that song. It's called Write One.
Wish there was a love song, one that I could sing you all night long. There's so many love songs, but none had ever said it all in one. You never see me say the things I need to say. There's not a masterpiece out there that paints that way. It's not a melody to tell you how I feel. Not a symphony of poetry that will fade on, ring true. I wish I could.
It's very new, isn't it?
Not a symphony of poetry that will fade on, ring true.
That's it.
I wish I could find one. So I'm gonna write one for you.
Sorry, Jules, to stuff up your song.
Another word for beautiful. So you know I see inside your soul. We'll settle for the usual. Not gonna use a word. Right. You never see me say the things I need to say. There's
not a masterpiece out there that paints that way. It's not a melody to tell you how I feel. Not a symphony of poetry that will fade on into. I can't seem to find one, so I'm gonna write one. A song that never dies, that gives you all the feelings even after it's been played a million times or even more, like it's never been heard before. You never seem to say the things I need to say. There's not a masterpiece out there that paints that way. Not a symphony of poetry that will. Not a symphony of poetry that will. They don't bring true. I can't seem to find one, so I'm gonna write one for you.
I've been writing so many songs, and I can't wait to share them with you. I have been in that mode for so long, and it still spins me out that after 20 years, I love writing more than ever. But there's a song that was on my very first album, and Dave actually shared this story with me. He said this, he used to listen to this all the time. This is before Dave was in the band. He's been in the band for a long time now, but he used to listen to this song all the time as he went to bed, and he almost made me cry because he was like, and now, like, it's cool for me because I'm playing this with you on stage now. And Dave, the feeling is mutual. You're an absolute freak musician, and I love you. But this song, I would say it's my favorite song from my very first album. I recorded that album in 5 days. 5 days, like right after winning Idol, I had to quickly get this album done and release it, and it was nuts. But I recorded a whole bunch of songs, and I think this one is my favorite. It's called My Beautiful Friend.
My beautiful. If you ever feel there's no strength left inside you, just know I'm by your side and holding your hand tight. Sometimes the moon is on, the light you need to guide you through the darkest night.
Okay, this one I'm excited for. I was a massive fan of Southern Suns growing up, and you know, throughout my life I've been lucky enough to work with so many incredible musicians, and I don't know if, I mean, there'd be a lot of Southern Suns fans in the crowd, but there's a lot of young people. If you want a really cool Aussie band to go back and listen to, Southern Suns were just unbelievable. Jack Jones, Irwin Thomas, incredible singer, incredible guitar player, and he played guitar on this next song. I've been so lucky, and this song was the title track of an album called Closer to the Sun, which somebody told me in soundcheck, when was that released? It was like 2006, but I love playing this song. It's been years, so I can't wait to play. It's called Closer to the Sun. Here we go.
Not an end and no one wins, yet you fight to keep the pace. Maybe I'll find a home in the heavens, hitch a ride on a shooting star, leave this place.
just one more thing before I go. Before I let you take the throne, you go right and I stay left. And if you ever get to me, know my name before I go. They love me then, they love you now. But don't forget there's one more round. Oh, the pain I know it well, but it hasn't kept me down. You think you got me figured out. Is my current single that I just released a few months ago.
Yeah!
And I get to sing it while my mama's actually in the audience.
Should've listened to my mama. She told me stay away from the drama. So be careful what you wish for. Take a bite, no more than a mouthful. And when I didn't take the warning, I always know in the morning. She caught me crying in the kitchen. Mama said, son, when you gonna listen? I've had some hits and misses. I know perfection is ambitious. This is the biggest decision I make. That's why I chose you. Yeah.
talking nonsense. When you're down, she'll get up, pick me up. And every time that you start acting up, she'll pull you back in line. That's when you know it's right. I've had some hits and misses. I know perfection is ambitious. This is the biggest decision I make. That's why I chose you.
Song, which is actually, it's going to be a song I'm going to release really soon, and it's something I wrote with someone who I really admire and who I'm a big fan of. His name's Sam Fisher. And Sam was at my house. He came over, we were going to write a song together, and I love his story. Sam's an Aussie artist. I added one of his songs. My mate Pat actually told me, he was like, you've got to listen to this song. And it was ages before it blew up and became a hit. It was like a long time. It's called The City. You would have heard it if you haven't. It's such a great song by an Aussie. The city's gonna break your heart. Woo! City's gonna love me and leave me alone. I love that song. And I added it and was listening to it for so long. And then like over a year later, it blew up and it became huge. And so Sam came over and I was like, Sam, firstly, like tell me about how come it took so long for this city to blow up. And he was like, I almost quit music. Like I was dropped by my label. My manager kind of was pretty awful to me, and they both dumped me. And I said, can I keep my masters? Can I keep my songs? And they were like, yeah, you can have them. Who cares? And then someone contacted him from TikTok and said, hey, I've added your song to one of my like viral videos. And he was like, I've been wondering why this has been going crazy and streaming so much. And it was TikTok that blew up his song everywhere. But he was like, I nearly quit music. And then we started talking about how much we love music and how it changed our lives. And so we thought we'd write a love song to music. And it's called Antidote. I may cry while I sing this.
Funny how I hate it when I'm here, but here I am again. Like I was made to mend, but mending never seemed to make it end. And oh, there you go, making it all make sense. It's funny how you find the words, I've never found a way to say. Find a way to make a masterpiece out of the mess I've made. But oh, there you go, making it all okay. You take the weight off my shoulder. You make it safe to get over. When I'm losing light, when I'm tipping over. Broken, my antidote.
pardon me, but pardon, put it back again. Oh, because I believe it is exactly where you've always been. I can't remember living like before. Oh, I adore you. No, everything would be in pieces if it weren't for you. Oh, it's funny how I almost walked away from the very thing that saved me.
Song. I've worked on that song for over a year. I can't wait till you hear this. It's probably one of the most, I don't know, for me, it's so impactful for me because I know that people are going to just find their antidote. I love writing songs that people make their own story. It's the best thing about being a songwriter, and I know that people will have their antidote, their thing. Great sign, by the way. I love the lights around it. Let's change the subject. But we all need that thing. Sometimes it's a person and it's different at various stages of our life, but that thing that just gets us through. And to sing that song here after 20 years, like, music has changed my life. It really has. And the people that I've got to meet, the stories that I've got to absorb over the years, it's all been because of you guys, and I'm so, so grateful. Should we dance?
Yeah!
I said, should we dance? Come on. It's your crew. It's got me frozen like ice. Fixating on you, but I think it's time to leave. Cause of you, I'm blinded to the antiquity. But baby, potentially, so get me out of here before I lose my mind. For another towel. Oh, Gaz, did you? Is that used? I want your weird sweat on my face. I'm joking. I love this man. Gary was best man at my wedding. How are we going for time? We're good for time. Are we all right? When I'm playing indoors, there's normally not like a restriction on chat and everything. I just however long it goes, but they're very strict here, which is fine. It's outdoors, they've got neighbours, and you can't keep the cicadas up all night. But this is my favourite part of the show because I get to attempt something that is pretty special for me. See, back in the day, my first single was Angels Brought Me. Yes. But here's a fun fact. Both me and Shannon had to sing Angels Brought Me Here. So he recorded a whole version of Angels Brought Me Here because we didn't know who was going to win until the end, and then whoever wins sings that song. And so there's a version out there, I've heard it, of Shannon singing Angels Brought Me Here. But I've always wondered what would it sound like if I was to sing Shannon's first ever single of What About Me? So we're going to attempt that.
here we go.
There's a little boy waiting at the corner of a corner shop. He's been waiting out there, waiting.
Just doesn't feel right, does it? It feels forced, if anything, a bit forced. Lacking, what would you say it's lacking? A bit of grit, a little bit of muscle, a bit of country heart. But I do know somebody who does a mean version of this song.
I'm gonna bring Shannon out.
He's a very, very special man to me, someone who I will be friends with until the day I pass. His name is Shannon Knight. It's the real deal, guys.
There's a little boy waiting at the counter of the corner shop. He's been waiting down there, waiting half the day. He never ever see him from the top. He gets pushed around, knocked to the ground. He gets to his feet and he says, what about me? It isn't fair. I'm bound up, now I want my share. Can't you see? I wanna live. Serving at the counter of the corner shop. She's been waiting back there, waiting for her dreams. Her dreams walk in and out and they never stop. Oh yeah, she's not too proud to cry out loud. She runs to the street and she screams, what about me? It isn't fair.
Exactly what you see, the most kind, humble. He's tough too. He was always tough. I always remember Shannon's not someone you mess with, and you've seen that new Jetstar ad, he is yoked. He's a beast, but my God, he's a kind, loyal, incredible human being and so ridiculously talented. I was honored, Shannon, to share the stage with you right here in this precinct.
And 20 years later to get to share it with him again is really special to me and pretty cool, right? Thank you, Shannon. Let's give it up for him one more time. Stay standing, please. It's Monday. I know it's Monday. Monday's normally a little bit sleepy and, you know, start of the week and all that. We are not far from Christmas. If you can, let's stand and let's sing this song. It's the last song. You better help me sing. I've got a big choir in this room.
Vegas, living like we're famous, family's made me crazy. But your book ran out of pages, and now I wish I never waited. Tell your heart about the moments in my life, the ones I got to share with you would probably be favorite. I know you're looking down on us, listen, you bro, hope you're proud of us, at least I know you.
Look at that person next to you and sing this chorus, cause now you're singing in a choir.
Call, we'll catch up next week, and then it gets to next week, and listen to the next week.
And then before you know, we are feeling old, asking ourselves, where did my friends go? So don't wait till they go. Somebody's singing in the choir. Now you're dancing in the crew. You ain't doing it so. We all got it with you. No one can put out your fire. Nobody's feeling your shoes.
Friend, I'm gonna see you again. And when I do, you better have a part for me. You sing the melody and I take the harmony. Cause we ain't done making music yet. We got some more sound checks, and this time we're gonna have about a million voices.
Thank you.
song. Gotcha.
I'm about to do something which it requires some crowd participation. It was my very first single. And this is the last show. I'm only doing these two shows. They were thank you shows, so I need to thank you. Of course, Live Nation had put this on as well. The Opera House. My gosh, what an iconic venue. This was so beautiful for me. And there's so many people I could sit here and spend time thanking, but I think they all know who you are. But for those who don't, if you don't know how grateful I am so, so, so grateful for the last 20 years. I've got heaps more music left in me, so let's make it to another 20 years. And we'll do a 40 year here, and I'll still be doing these ones, I promise. Help me sing "This Is Angels Brought Me Here."
Yes.
It's been a long and winding journey, but I'm finally here tonight. I'm picking up the pieces and walking back into the light, into the sunset of your glory, where my heart and future lie. There's nothing like that feeling when I look into your eyes. 'Cause my dreams came true when I found you. Get your phone torches out. My miracle.
it would be clear. I said you would know, and it would be clear. I love you so much. Please give it up for this incredible band. Please join me. Come and join me. Guys, thank you for making the effort. I will see you next year with some new music, with some touring and all of that sort of stuff. Have the best Christmas. Have the best, safest New Year. Please give it up for this band, this crew, the incredible people that have put this show on. I love you, I love you.